Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station update. We're joining the International Space Station Flight Control team on Leap Day here in the Space Station Flight Control Room at the Mission Control Center in Houston. The Orbit 2 team is on console at this time, and they're led by Flight Director Paul Dye with Jeremy Hansen in the CAPCOM seat. You can see Dye here in the white shirt next to Hansen in the blue shirt. On board the International Space Station, the Expedition 30 crew has been awake since midnight Central Time, and they're now more than halfway through their day. They are U.S. Commander Dan Burbank and U.S. Flight Engineer Don Pettit, European Flight Engineer Andrei Kuipers, and Russian Flight Engineers Oleg Kononenko, Anton Shkaplerov, and Anatoly Ivanishin. Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin launched the station in their Russian Soyuz TMA-22 vehicle on November 13th and docked to the space station on November 15th, so they're working on their 108th day in space and their 106th day at the space station. Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit followed them into space in their Soyuz TMA-03M on December 21st and arrived at the station on December 23rd, so they're working on their 71st day in space and their 69th day at the space station. Crew is currently 238 miles above the Indian Sea, just off the coast of India, heading southeast towards the coast of Australia. Their average altitude is a little higher today than it was yesterday, thanks to a successful reboost performed earlier this morning. Even though there's plenty of time left in both segments of the crew's stay, there's work going on now to get ready for their departure. To get into the correct position for the undocking of Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin's Soyuz, the Zvezda module's thrusters were fired earlier this morning for 1 minute and 16 seconds at 4:12 a.m. Central Time. That increased the station's altitude to 254 by 232 miles. Besides the Soyuz undocking, that also puts the station in a good place for the arrival of the next Progress and the three crew members that will take Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin's place in their Soyuz. That is Joe Acaba, Gennady Padalka, and Sergei Revin, you can see here. They're scheduled to launch in May in their Soyuz TMA-04M, which actually just arrived in Baikonur, Kazakhstan for its final testing on Monday. We have a photo of that arrival at the Baikonur Cosmodrome to show you. That again was taken on Monday in Baikonur, Kazakhstan. Of course, there's still plenty of work to be done in the meantime. Today, the crew had a large variety of experiments and maintenance going on. Commander Dan Burbank was again working on the ongoing update of the station's computers with the Enhanced Processor and Integrated Communications, or EPIC as it's called. Flight Engineer Don Pettit is in the process of actually performing the checkout of the station's combustion chamber that he spent time yesterday getting ready for. That facility is used for microgravity research on droplet, solid fuel, or gaseous fuel combustion. He also did a camera checkout for the BCAT-6, or Binary Colloidal Alloy Test Number 6, which looks at how liquids and gases interact with each other in mixtures and microgravity. Meanwhile, Flight Engineer Andrei Kuipers did some work with the Cubic 3 experiment. Cubic is a small, temperature-controlled incubator, or cooler, with removable inserts designed for self-contained automatic microgravity experiments with seeds, cells, and small animals. On the Russian side of the station, there are several other experiments in work. Anton Shkaplerov worked with the Topologia study, which looks to identify objectives that can be used to assess the mental state of crew members during long-term space flights. Anatoly Ivanishin worked with both the identification and Matryoshka experiments. First of those looks at how dynamic events such as today's reboost affect the structure of the space station, and the other looks at the radiation levels inside of the space station. And Oleg Kononenko spent some time on the bar experiment today, which is meant to assess methods for detecting loss of pressure inside the space station. So that's what's going on in space today, and this is Mission Control Houston.